and welcome to today's class. So we were looking at the chapter some basic concepts in geometry from mathematics part 2. Let us quickly begin with the recap on this chapter, what we did in the last class. So we started with what is the meaning of geometry, which means earth measuring or measuring earth, which is related to construction and how it helps in surveying, in astronomy, navigation and building. We also did points, lines and planes. So point is like a location in space and it has no dimensions, it has no length, no width and no thickness, right? And we saw next was line. That line is a set of connected points. If we club up the points together to connect with each other and that they are lying on a straight line, then that becomes a line and it has no dimension. It can be of any thickness. It has no width or thickness, right? And it has infinite length. And that's how we represent a line using two arrowheads at the ends. And next we saw a plane. So a plane is an infinite large flat surface and it has two dimensions, all right? But it has no thickness. Again, it has infinite length and infinite width. And that is how a plane, we represent a plane like that. And then we also saw the concept on betweenness, which is like if there are three points and they are collinear, then how a point between two points can be represented using this formula. So for the first one, for the first condition, for the first case, if you see point Q is between P and R, and that's how we represent it. The distance P, Q plus distance Q, R is equal to distance P, R. If this is true, then we say that point Q lies between P and R. Okay, and this is how we represent it, P dash Q dash R. That is point Q lies between point P and R. Then case two is where R is lying between the points P and Q. And case three is, in case three, you can check point P lies between R and Q. So these are the three cases for a given set of three points wherein we can show betweenness using these three different cases. All right, and next is we saw a very important point, like the distance. Suppose we find distance, then how to find distance? Like if we have two points, then the distance of between those two points can be calculated by subtracting the smaller coordinate from the larger coordinate, right? And the distance between any two points is a non-negative real number. Always the distance has to be positive. It won't be negative, right? And so with that, we begin with today's part. That is, we will be looking at what is a line, what is a line segment, what is the ray, then what is angle. We will be looking at few more basic concepts of geometry. So if you look at the picture on board, the first thing is a line, and we will be looking at few basic things about, like how do we model is means how it looks like or how we draw it, then how is it named, what are the simple basic facts about it, and how do we represent it, right? So for example, for a line, we draw it with two arrowheads at the ends, and then you can see here we draw both the ends have arrows, and to name it, we can use small letters or we can use capital letters like that. So it can be named as one, using one letter, one small letter, like line M, that is line M, or we can use two letters to represent it in this way over here, line AH or line HA. It's one and the same thing. And the fact about a line is that it doesn't have width or height. It has infinite length. Okay. If we look at the next part, which is segment, for a segment, we can say that the end points are points. Okay. Those are not arrowheads. So line segment is a part of line with a specific length. All right. It has two end points. So it has two specific end points. And we can say that it has a particular or specific length. And how do we represent it? So we represent it using two capital letters. Like here you can just check the words used. It can be written as line segment ND or it can be written as line segment DN. Okay. And we can name it both the way. It can be backwards or it can be forwards also. Next we see ray. What is the meaning of ray? So if one point, one end is a point and if the other end has an arrow, then that becomes a ray. Remember that ray is directional, all right, because it begins at the point and it moves to as one end point that goes through the and the other is it goes through it through forever, like, okay. And how do we represent it? So again, we use two capital letters. Like here you can see we represent it as length LE, ray LE, like that. And we denote an arrow on top of this, stating that this ray starts at L and ends at E, or it goes on forever on the other point. Okay, so here we have to be very careful when we are naming it, because we have to write the first letter to be the end point. This should be the first letter. We cannot write it as EL. That would be wrong. So ray LE is how we denote it. All right. With that, we look at the next concept, that is angle. If two rays, they connect at one point, that becomes an angle. Okay. So two rays which are joined together by an end point, they have a common starting point. All right. That becomes an angle. So either the letter in the middle or the three letters are used to name it. Okay. So the very basic part is that when naming an angle, we need to remember that the vertex will always lie at the center. The vertex has to be always at the center. Okay. So here you can see, we can name it as angle CAR, or we can name it as angle RAC, or we can simply use the center vertex letter, that is angle A, or we can use the number also, which is represented, which is used to represent this angle, which is angle 3, like that. And then plane, we have looked at this part, plane and a point. Like in comparative format, when you study, it is very easy to remember. So that's why this is a complete chart on the basic concepts, how the model looks like, what are the basic things we need to know when we are drawing them, and then how we name it and the facts about it. Okay. With that, we look at what are congruent segments. Now the word congruent itself means that they would be equal in length. Segment means it is a part of the line with a particular length, right? So if we look at the diagram, suppose these are the two segments, segment AB and segment CD, then we can say that these two segments are congruent, right? Because they have equal lengths. So if the length of the two segments is equal, then we say that the segments are congruent. okay? And this is how we represent it. Either we can represent it using the letter L, that is the length. Length AB is equal to length CD, or we can write it out like that. Segment AB is congruent to segment CD. And then we look at some other properties of congruent segments. The first is reflexivity. Now, this is very easy to understand actually, but you need to look at all three of them in a comparative manner. So, for reflexivity, we use only one line segment. So, here you can see segment AB is congruent to itself. So, that means reflexivity. Reflexivity, if you look at the word, it has a part called reflex or reflecting, right? So reflection means what? Like we look into the mirror, we see the same thing, right? So segment AB is congruent to itself, right? So when we are comparing the thing with itself, the segment with itself, we say that is reflexivity. Remember, here it will be only one segment that we are comparing with, okay? And then we look at the other property, which is symmetry. For symmetry, we need two segments. All right. So symmetry means what? If AB is congruent to CD, then CD will be congruent to AB. All right. I'll repeat it once again. For symmetry, we require at least two segments, right? Segment AB will be, if segment AB is congruent to segment CD, then segment CD will also be congruent to AB, vice versa. All right. So that is symmetry. For reflexivity, we need only one line segment. And for symmetry, we require two line segments. So if AB is congruent to CD, then CD will be congruent to AB, vice versa. All right. And then the third property, that is transitivity. Now for transitivity, we require three segments. All right. So just check, here we have used segment AB, segment CD, and segment EF, all right? That is for transitivity. So if segment AB is congruent to segment CD and segment CD is congruent to EF, that actually means that AB is congruent to CD and CD is congruent to EF, then automatically segment AB will be congruent to segment EF, like that. Okay, so it's like this. AB is congruent to CD and CD is congruent to EF. Then clearly these two, if we remove both of them, it's like AB is congruent to EF. This is called as transitivity. So if you look at it in comparative way, clearly you can see reflexivity is with itself, like it's like a mirror image. So a segment, when compared to itself, it is always congruent to itself, right? That is reflexivity. Symmetry means we look at two line segments. It's like if one segment is congruent to other, then the other one is congruent back to the first one. And transitivity, we require three segments. If first is congruent to second, and second is congruent to third, then automatically first is congruent to the third one. All right, that is transitivity. Then next we look at a very basic concept, midpoint of a segment. All right, and here AMB denotes that M is the point which lies between A and B. This is betweenness. A dash M dash B is betweenness. All right, but if specifically it is mentioned that segment AM is congruent to segment MB, then we can say that M is the midpoint of segment AB, like that. So every segment has one and only one midpoint. Yes, this is a fact again, because if we have a segment, of course, there will be only one point which will make or which will break that segment into two equal parts. Okay. With that, we look at the next part, or else we can add one more basic fact over here. Instead of writing like this, segment AM is congruent to segment MB, we can write it as segment AM is equal to segment MB, which is equal to half of segment AB. All right, it is exactly half of it. Next, we look at the next concept, which is comparison of line segments. So if length of segment AB is less than the length of segment CD, it is written as segment AB is less than CD, or it can be also written as segment CD is greater than segment CD. All right, so it is just comparison which we have done in lower classes, right? So simple way, how do you compare? You just look at both the lengths, right? And it can happen that you may be asked to find the length first, and then you would be asked to compare it. Okay, so how do we compare it? It is just simple thing, less than or greater than. You use using that we can compare the segments. Now, perpendicularity of segments or rays. This is a concept which is used, or it is used till higher classes also. So let us understand this. Perpendicularity means what? It has the word perpendicular, and perpendicular means 90 degree. Okay, so if two rays or two segments, they intersect each other at 90 degree, then they are said to be perpendicular to each other. So perpendicularity means it is the angle 90 degree. So if two rays or two segments, they intersect each other at 90 degree, then we say that they are perpendicular to each other. Okay, and how do we denote it? We denote it using the symbol, which is like a reciprocal of, or we flip, if we flip the letter capital T, you see this is the symbol. Okay, so a symbol of perpendicularity. Segment AB is perpendicular to the line CD. And we can replace that word line CD. Again, we can use segment over there. So here we can replace that line CD with segment also, or we can use the word ray CD, or it can be ray DC as well, right? Because we see these are two points used, C and D over there. Okay, fine. With that, we will now quickly look at the exercise, which is practice set 1.2. Yes, so let us look at the applications of what we have done now. Okay, so here the first question says, the following table shows points on a number line and their coordinates. Decide whether the pairs of segments given below the table are congruent or not. So are they congruent or not? We have to identify this. So how do we begin? First, for the first problem, for the first part, we are given segment DE and segment AB. So we start with finding the distance of segment DE, segment AB, and then we will compare it. Okay, so let's begin. We start with finding the length of DE. First, we need to identify or know the coordinates, right? So we write it like this. Coordinate of point D. What is the coordinate of point D? That is 7, negative 7. And the coordinate of point E. Coordinate of point E is, yes, that is equals to 9. And we see which is the greater one here. It's 9 greater than negative 6. Therefore, we can say the distance D, E is equal to, the formula is like we subtract the smaller number from the greater number, right? So the greater here is, the greater number is 9 minus negative 7. That would be 9. Negative, negative becomes positive, and that would be 16. So here segment DE equals to 16, and then we find out the length of segment AB. So we follow the same process. We write down first the coordinates. So coordinate of point A is -3. And what is the coordinate of other point? That is B. So coordinate of point B, that is equal to 5. And we see that 5 is greater than -3. Therefore, the distance A comma B is equal to greater minus smaller. So the greater number here is 5. 5 minus -3, that would be 5 plus 3, and that is 8. So now check, are both the lengths equal? So length of segment AB, that is equal to 8. And how do we denote this? So simply we can write it as, length of DE. We got the length of DE to be 16 and length of AB to be 8. And we see that both of them are not equal. Lengths are not equal. Length of DE is not equal to length of AB. And therefore we can say that the segments are not equal. So segment DE is not equal to segment AB, like that. That concludes the first question. Let us look at another part of the same question. So here we have to check if segment BC is congruent to segment AB, fine? So we repeat the same process. We start with the coordinate of B. What is the coordinate of point B? That is equal to 5. And what is the coordinate of C? So coordinate of point C is equal to 2. We see that 5 is greater than 2. So therefore, the distance between the points B and C is equals to 3 minus 2, which is equals to 1. And next we find the distance between AD. All right. So that would be the coordinate. We first look at the coordinate. So coordinate of point A is equal to -3, and the coordinate of point D, that is equals to a -7. We know here the number which is on the left is smaller, right? So -3 is greater than -7. Right, because -7 is on the left hand side. So here therefore the distance between the points A comma D will be greater minus the smaller. So -3, negative and negative makes a positive, and that would be 7 minus 3 is 4, right? So distance between A comma D equals to 4. And now if you compare both of them, both the lengths, distance B comma C equals to 1, we see that both the lengths are not equal, right? We see that both the lengths are not equal. So we can state here that length of BC is not equal to length of AD. Remember, when we are using the letter L, we don't put a comma, all right? So length of BC is not equal to length of AD. Therefore, we can say that segment BC is not equal to segment AD, like that. Okay, let us look at the third problem also. So segment BE and segment AD, we are comparing these two now, and we have to check if they are congruent. So the same process, what are the coordinates? So coordinate of point B is equal to 5, and the coordinate of the other point, coordinate of point E, that is equal to 9. Therefore, the distance between the points B and E is equals to greater minus smaller, which is equals to 4. So we got the length of BE, that is equals to 4. We look at the distance of the next set, the next segment. So here the coordinate of point A, what is the coordinate of point A? Yes, students, coordinate of point A is, I hope you all are solving it with me. So coordinate of point A is -3. And what is the coordinate of the other point? So coordinate of point E, that is equal to, yes, we need to find AD. So we took A and now we need to use the coordinate of point D. So coordinate of point D is -7, right? So therefore distance between A comma D, that is equals to negative, which is the greater minus smaller. So greater here is -3 minus of -7, that is equals to -3, +7, which is 4. So here we got the length of AD, that is equal to 4. And that's how we can say that both the lengths are equal. Here we got both the lengths are equal. Length of BE is equal to length of AD, which is equals to 4. Therefore, we can say that segment BE is congruent to segment AD. All right, I hope this is very clear. How to check if the given two segments are congruent. All right, so first we find the lengths by using the distance formula, and then we check or we compare if both the values are equal, then we say yes, if they are congruent. And if both are not equal, then we say they are not congruent. Okay, let us look at the next question, question number 2 of practice set 1.2. Here we are given that point M is the midpoint of segment AB and AB is equal to 8, then we need to find the length of AM. So let us quickly draw a diagram of this. So suppose this is length AB, this is segment AB, this is A over here, A, and the other end point is B, and the total length is 8. We need to find the length of AM such that M is the midpoint of this segment. So we draw M over here, these two sides are equal, right? And we know that if it's a midpoint, then of course, we just need to write it out like this. M is the midpoint. It is the midpoint of segment AB. Therefore, we can say that AM, segment AM will be congruent or equal to segment BM. And that will be, of course, equal to half of the segment AB, right? And what are we asked to find? We are asked to find the length of AM. So clearly, length of AM has to be half of length of AB, right? Which will be half of the length of AB is given to be 8, right? So half of 8, which is equals to 4. Thus, we have got the length AM to be 4. Okay, that completes the solution to this problem. Let us look at the next question, question number 3. Point P is the midpoint of segment CD. If CP equals to 2.5, we are asked to find the length of CD. Okay, so again, if we draw a diagram, how would that look like? We have the end points to be C and D. So the end points are C and D, and it is given that P is the midpoint of segment CD. So suppose this is the point P and these two sides are equal. Why? Because P is the midpoint, right? And we are given that CP equals to 2.5. So automatically this will be also 2.5, right? If both of them are 2.5 and 2.5, what will be the length of CD? Adding them up, correct? That would be 5, right? But how do we write the steps? So we begin with stating whatever is given. So we are given that point P is midpoint. It is the midpoint of segment CD. Therefore, we can say segment CP, or the length of CP will be equal to length of PD. And of course, that is equal to 2.5, which is given in the question, right? And then since the diagram looks like C dash P dash D, P is a point between C and D. Therefore, what can we say? We can say that distance of CD will be equal to distance between CP plus the distance between PD, right? So what is the distance of CP? That is 2.5, and distance between PD is 2.5. Adding them up, we get the distance of C comma D to be 5, correct? And that's how we can say if the distance is 5, then the length is also same, that is equal to 5. All right, that is how we can show the steps. Right, let us look at the next problem. Question number 4. So here we are given 3 segments, AB, BP and AP. Those are the 3 segments, and we are asked to compare them. Now, what do you mean by compare? Either write them in ascending order or put them in descending order. All right. So we start with writing them out in ascending order. All right. So it will be 2 is first, next is 3.4, and the next distance would be 5. The segment with 2 is BP. Then the segment with 3.4 is AP, and the segment with the distance 5 is AB. We just need to put the comparison sign, and that completes the solution. Okay, so compare the segments. This can be asked for 1 mark. So how do we compare them? We are just comparing their distances, or we are just comparing their lengths, and we just put it in order, either in ascending order or in descending order. All right, so, or it can be also written as AB is greater than AP, which is greater than BP, like that. Okay, we move to question number 5, which is a very interesting question, and it can be asked for 3 to 4 marks. So the first question, here we are given a number line, all right? We are given a number line, and it states, write the answers to the following questions with the reference of this figure. Write the name of the opposite ray of ray RP. Okay, so first we are asked to write the name of the ray which is opposite to ray RP. If I wish to highlight the ray RP, it is this point. It is starting at that point and moving in the other, in towards P. Towards P and moving to infinity. So this is the ray RP. Clearly, the opposite ray would be starting at the same point, okay, it would start at the same point, but it would move in the opposite direction. That is, it would be either moving towards S or it would be moving towards T, and it moves to till infinity, right? So we can say it will be ray RS or it will be ray RT. Both are one and same. Okay, so let me put up the names for both of them. Okay, I'll just add names for both of them. So, and answer to the first one is, answer to the first question is, it will be either ray RS, or we can say it is ray RT, like that. Okay. The second question now, write the intersection set of ray PQ and ray RP. So, which is ray PQ? P over here, and Q means we move towards Q like that. So this is the first ray, and other ray is ray RP. Okay, so let me use other color. RP means it starts at point R and move towards P. So ray RP is this one. Okay, and what are we asked to do? We are asked to write the intersection set of both of them, right? Now, what do you mean by intersection? You have done this in the chapter sets, right? Intersection. The word intersection means which is common in both of them. Okay, so if you look at the yellow line and if you look at the red line, it's the ray, of course, at the yellow ray and at the red ray, if you look at them, which is the common region? The intersection set is the common region. So clearly, the common region over here is the ray PQ, right? It starts at P and goes till infinity. So for the second one, the answer for this is ray PQ. Okay, the common region, that is the intersection set, will be ray PQ. So intersection set can also be said to be the common region, okay, and that is ray PQ. We look at the third question now. Write the union set of segment PQ and segment QR. So which is the segment PQ here? Segment PQ is over here, P to Q, and the other one is segment QR. So segment QR is here. We are asked to write the union of this. Okay, we are asked to write the union of this. Union set means everything that covers RQ and that covers PQ. Okay, so union set will be all those shaded part together combined. Okay, all the red and green part together combined. So clearly this will be segment RQ, right? Because red segment is the greater one, so the answer will be the greater segment itself for union, okay, because that covers the maximum region. So combination of both of them together is union set. So here for the third question, the union will be segment RQ. Union set means the region all together. So for third one, the answer is segment RQ, or we can write it as segment QR. It's one and the same thing. Okay, we look at fourth one now. So for fourth one, state the rays of which segment QR is a subset. So it's like subset means a part of it, a smaller part of it. Okay, subset means a part of it. So state the rays of which segment QR is a subset. So we first highlight segment QR. So just check, QR is this part. All right, it's this part. And we are asked to find, or we are asked to state all the rays which are a part of this complete segment RQ. Okay, so we can say that we can see there are two parts, there are two small segments, that is one is RP and other is PQ, right? And also when we say subset means itself also. Okay, so everything that is, like if we look at a example, let us look at a numerical example. Okay students, so if we look at a numerical example, let's say A is a set and it has the numbers so suppose we have a set A and it has the numbers 1, 2, 3, then the subset will be 1, or it will be 2, or it will be 3, or it will be everything. Okay, let us not take the three numbers. Suppose I take only two numbers. Okay, let's say these are only the two numbers. So the subset will be, first we take single of the numbers, so 1 and 2 separate, and the next choice will be all of them together, and the last choice is empty set. Okay, for this question, if you look at the question, it says segment QR. So if I highlight QR, clearly we can see in QR there are two parts, right? In QR there are two parts, one is RP and other is PQ. So RP and other is PQ, and of course the segment itself. So the set will include three of these segments. We don't have this this empty symbol, right? We cannot show or represent the empty segment like that, right? A segment with no distance is nothing, correct? So for this question, when they are asking us to write the rays which are a part of this, we will be writing out three parts: RP, segment PQ, and the complete segment itself. Okay, so for the fourth one, for the fourth one, the answer can be written as it will be segment RP, or it will be segment PQ, or the complete one, that is segment RQ itself. Okay, so this will be the subset of the rays of the segment RQ. All right, next we look at the fourth problem. Write the pair of opposite rays with common end point R. So starting at R, we need to write the opposite rays. Okay, this is the same question as which one? As the first one. Okay, first one, it's one and the same thing. So opposite rays which start at point R, either it will be going towards the Q or it will be going towards T. So the opposite rays are ray RT and ray RQ, or you can name it as ray RP and ray RS. Okay, choice is yours. We can name it in different ways. So for the fourth one, the opposite rays will be ray RS and ray, the other one is RP. Okay, you can write it as ray RQ and the other will be ray RT. Okay, so you can name it anyhow. Next, we look at the next question. It says sixth one, write any two rays with common ends, end point, with common end point S. So these two questions are of same kind. We start at point S and move to the right hand side. The ray can be named as RS or ray RP or ray RQ. And to the left hand side, it will be just ray ST. So for the fifth one, we can write the answer like this. It will be ray ST and ray SQ or SP anyhow. Okay, these rays are opposite to each other with the common, just a minute. It says write two rays and not the opposite rays, two rays. So we can write many rays here which are starting with common end point S. The starting point should be S. Okay, any two rays will work. No need to write out the opposite only. Only we can write any two of them. Write the intersection set of ray SP and ray ST. That's the last question over here for the problem number fifth. So ray SP and ray ST, let's highlight them. Ray SP is this one and the other is ray ST. So ST is to the other side, right? And let me denote this with yellow, SP. So SP and ST, we want the intersection set. Remember, the intersection set is the common, right? The common region between both of them, which is included in both the things. So what is included in ray SP and ray ST? This is a nice question. So clearly we can see that only the point S belongs to both the rays, ray SP and ray ST. Therefore, the answer for seventh one is point S. Okay, so let me write it here. For the seventh one, the answer, that is the intersection set, is point S, because it is there in both of them. So that completes question number five. And there's one more question, but we are out of time now. So for sixth one, you can take this as homework. All right. So let us quickly take a quick recap on what we did today. We saw a table, a chart format, which was this one, like comparing line, segment, ray, angle, plane, and point together. Then we did congruent segments, which means if the lengths are equal, then the segments are congruent. Then we saw three properties of congruent segments, which is reflexivity, symmetry, and transitivity. Reflexivity deals with the segment itself, right? That a segment is congruent to itself. Symmetry deals with two segments. It's like first segment is congruent to second, then the second is congruent to first. And transitivity deals with three segments. If the first segment is congruent to second and the second is congruent to third, then automatically first segment is congruent to the third one. and then we saw midpoint of a segment, it clearly states that any two parts of that segment with the point M will be half of the total length, right? And we also saw a few problems, application based problems on midpoint of a segment. Then we did this thing, comparison of segments, and also we saw application based question on comparison of segments. Then we saw perpendicularity of segments or rays. It clearly states that perpendicular means 90 degree. If two lines or two rays or two segments, they hit each other or the point of intersection is 90 degree, then we say that they are perpendicular to each other. And to denote it, we use that symbol, which is inverted T, which is inverted capital T. Okay, so that was all for today. Thank you everyone for joining. And let's meet tomorrow, same time.